God. Praise God. He had to reap way down for this old boy.
Oh, bless the Lord.
Praise God. We are up with some prayer. They still remember Sister Diane Green. Y'all got a prayer for Chris?
Yes. Go ahead, Sister Diane.
Somebody go.
And their main concern today was when they went to go put him under, the air pockets was going to get into his lungs or something. But I haven't heard how the surgery went because when they took him in, it was late. So I just left and went home. I was going to go back, but I just felt like I needed to be in church more. And just remember Robert's brother, Jerry. He is battling an ulcer on the bottom of his foot. And they're doing therapy on it, but they said the next step is going to be removing the foot. And he is really struggling, just really pray that it would get cleared up because they need to start dialysis on him because his kidneys is not working, but they can't start the dialysis until they get the foot here cleared up. So just really hold him up in prayer.
And
a lady named Kathy Ray, she's battling cancer, and I want everybody to remember her. And I got a friend, her name is Paula, and her son's fiance, they just had a little baby, but she just took her life Friday. And that little baby, that family needs some prayer.
Hey, and run out?
Yeah. Remember me in prayer, the Satan has been on my back for
almost 3 days now. And he's on the bridle, he's got the saddle, and the rattlesnake in front of him, and in front of him, he's still jumping. And I need your help with him. I got an attitude that's beyond belief. But I don't like to say something to people, I keep my mouth shut. And whenever, sometimes they catch the wrong way, they got a bad day, they got a bad day. And I don't like that.
Friends, we've known each other since I was 13 or so. We've been in Lake City one day, and her daughter really talked to Michael while we were having lunch. And she said she felt the Holy Spirit dealing with her what to tell him, and he was listening. Maybe we'll come to church tonight. I just pray that that fruit will grow.
Yes.
Thank
God.
Everyone
else?
Amen.
Yes. Thank God. If not, let's stand and take these knees to God. For the simple matter of the church. Praise God. Father, we just come to you right now, Lord, for these knees, Lord. We just pray, Lord, that you can reach down. Lord, and that touch them. You've heard each and every one of them, Father. Father, I just pray, Lord, that you just pass you the touch of the dying brain, Lord, that you just minister to her, Lord, and just touch her body, Father. Father, just touch the padded request, Lord, that you just reach down, Lord, and just touch them, Lord, in a mighty way. Sit down that request, Lord, I just pray, Lord, that you just touch them and minister to her, Father, in a mighty way, Lord, and one is step to you, Lord, and up there in the drug, Lord. I just pray, Lord, that you're going to reach down, Lord, and just touch him, Father, in a mighty way. And just be with our sister, Lord, that don't have the operation on the eyes, Lord. I just pray, Lord, that you just touch and minister to her, Father. Father, I just pray, Lord, that you just be with Sister Louise, Lord, that you just minister to her, Father. And Father, just be with them, Lord, if they're on vacation next week, Lord, that you just touch them. Lord, in a mighty way, Lord, and just watch over them, Lord, if they out there on that roof, Father, that you just keep them, Lord. Father, I just pray, Lord, that you just be with Brother Baker's request, Lord, that you just touch him, Father, in a mighty way, that you just minister to him, Father. And Sister Baker, Lord, and request on her, Father, I just pray, Lord, that you just touch him and minister to him, Father, in a mighty way, Lord. Father, just be with Randy Fingers, Lord, and request, Lord. I just pray, Lord, that you just reach down, Lord, and just touch him, Father, in a mighty way, Lord. And catch the request, Lord. I just pray, Lord, that you just be with it. One, Lord, and that thing, Lord, that you just touch him, Father, in a mighty way, Lord, that you just work in his life, Father. Father, don't request, Lord. I just pray, Lord, that you just touch him. This request, Lord, that you just minister to them. Lord, who's making request for, Lord, that you just touch them. Father, in a mighty way, Lord, that you just work in their lives, Father. Father, I just pray, Lord, that you just be with this service, Lord, that you just minister to it, Lord, in a mighty way. And Father, just be with this church, Father, that you just reach down, Lord, and just touch it and bless it, Father, in a mighty way, Lord. Father, just be with us now, Lord, as we go in this service, Lord, that you just minister to us, Lord, in a mighty way, and we just thank you in Christ's name. Amen. 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 Praise God, praise God. It's time to take the offering. Go to back on you stand and ask the blessing.
Lord, again, we thank you for this opportunity back in our house, Lord. We ask you to touch each and every prayer request is asked tonight, Lord, and also bless those who give, and those who can't give, may be able to give the next 24 hours. God, in service, in service tonight, and make us stronger before we walk out these doors. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Is she singing?
I wrote a letter to Kaylee Joyner, and I just got a letter back, and he's doing well. I'll just read it quickly. Dear Sister Patty, I just got your letter. I may not be able to see this. It's good to hear from you. It sounds like a lot has happened since I left, and I just briefly told him about some of the issues where the devil was fighting and some of the other good things that were happening. He said, I pray things are going better over there since you have written the letter. I'm graduating boot camp in a week, which was today.
Praise God.
I got my beret now, so I officially made it into the Army. He doesn't say, I don't think, yet. It doesn't say how long boot camp is going to be, I don't think. But he said, anyway, after boot camp, I'm going to ALT, which he doesn't explain,
for 7 weeks. Training.
I'm sorry?
Advanced individual training. That's what his job is going to be.
It's not 7 weeks over there.
Okay. Going to ALT or AIT for 7 weeks to learn how to be a chaplain's assistant. I've been going to church every Sunday. It has been a hard 9 weeks, and I'm glad it's almost over. You have no idea how hard it is to run in full armor until you have done it. The vest and helmet weigh a lot on your shoulders. I hope I don't have to wear it often. I might be going to Afghanistan. I'm not sure. The drill sergeants say most of us will be deployed, but I would spend most of my time on base. I'm hoping to go to Israel. We don't get the news here, so I don't really know what's going on in the world. We've been spending this last week cleaning our weapons and cleaning the barracks. I'm still recovering from a 10-mile march we did with a rucksack on our back. It took almost 6 hours. It's been really hot here, too. It reached 102 degrees today, the day you wrote it, which was the 2nd. 23rd, sorry. It'll be the 2nd. We've had a few thunderstorms also. One of them was when I was camping in the woods. That was an experience. He writes very small. I hope to come home for a few weeks after ALT or AIT. I would like to see my church family again, but boot camp has been really exhausting. I graduate on July 1st. My AITA, whatever, will be at Fort Jackson, so I'll be here on July the 4th, so I'm sure something will be going on. I should have my Facebook back up in a whatever that is. I have it temporarily disabled and the internet, just to let you know, no one can send me any more mail, because it takes a long time to reach me, and I won't be here much longer. I'm going to leave off right here. I'm keeping everyone in my prayers. Love you, Caleb. So we can pray.
Praise the Lord. Let's keep Caleb in our prayers. I mean, if we can keep those children from walking in front of that frequency. Amen. Praise the Lord. This song. How many, when you get to heaven, get your mansion? Or are you going to say, well, it's my mansion, it's beautiful, and I'm not going to allow it to come over and visit me? But this song says, you're all invited to my mansion. In my life I struggle. those girls. Amy, amen. He told me this morning they probably would not make it due to the dog, to the girls being sick. Little Annabella was having nosebleeds, and Isabella was not well. So he said they probably wouldn't be here, and I meant to mention before service that the children would not be going to the back because there would, Brother John called me after I left the property and said they probably would not have the class tonight. But we're glad you're here, and just keep praying because John and Brandy will be back also in a minute. Amen. And many, many others, amen. I would have loved to have sung many more songs tonight, but I came back tonight after very much Bible reading through this last week. It was a blessing, but I have, most of the week, at least half the week last week, God was just dealing with my mind and speaking to me on Thursday and Friday morning and right through the weekend, Monday, Tuesday, and again today. My wife and I were talking, and I just want to tell you tonight, and fact of the matter is, I believe there are some that are not here tonight that were supposed to be here to hear this message. Amen. But I promised God that I would go ahead and preach it, and want to obey Him tonight and what His direction would be. Amen. If you have your Bibles tonight, turn with me over to Matthew's Gospel, chapter 24. When you turn to Matthew 24, generally you begin to think, well, we're going to be discussing or talking or preaching or listening and hearing about the last days. Also, as you turn to Matthew 24, hold your place there in verse 32, Matthew 24 and 32 through 44. And then go over to the book with me, over to the book of 2 Peter. 2 Peter chapter 3. 2 Peter chapter 3. We may not get to read all of 2 Peter, or maybe none of 2 Peter, unless the Lord wills that we do so. Amen. 2 Peter, or Matthew 24, 32 through 44, and then 2 Peter 3, 1 through 18. I'd like to, with the help of God, and I know He'll help us tonight, to speak with this thought in mind: a world in chaos. A world in chaos. A church asleep. A world in chaos and a church asleep. Read with me, if you will, over in Matthew chapter 24, beginning to read in verse number 32. Now learn a parable of the fig tree. When his branch is yet tender and putteth forth leaves, you know that summer is nigh. So likewise ye, when ye shall see all these things, know that it is near, even at the doors. Verily I say unto you, this generation shall not pass till all these things be fulfilled. What generation was Christ talking about here? He was talking about that generation that would be here when Jesus returns. This generation shall not pass. Verily I say unto you, this generation shall not pass till all these things be fulfilled. Heaven and earth shall pass away, but my words shall never or shall not pass away. But of that day and hour knoweth no man, no, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only. But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered into the ark. Let me just add to this. There are still thoughts of man that says, time is going as it always has. Nothing is changing. We'll wake up tomorrow and everything will be the same as it was the day before.
Where are, people are crying, where are the signs of his coming? Read with me in verse 38 again. For as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered into the ark, knew not until the flood came and took them all away, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. I want us to remember verse 39 tonight. So, and knew not until the flood came and took them all away, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. Then shall two be in the field. Honey, we're going to have them come out of the booth.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. And knew not until the flood came and took them all away, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. Then shall two be in the field, the one shall be taken and the other left. Two women shall be grinding at the meal, the one shall be taken and the other left. Watch therefore, for you know not what hour your Lord doth come. But know this, that if the good man of the house had known in what watch the thief would come, he would have watched.
That's right.
And would not have suffered his house to be broken up. Is that true?
Yes.
Amen.
If we have goods, let us pray. Heavenly Father, God, this is your word. This, Lord, I pray to hear your voice. God, the same way that God just spoke to me, God, in days gone by. I pray that, God, you would receive honor tonight. That you would receive praise and glory. God, I pray, Lord, will you rain upon us tonight by your Spirit. Will you open our minds, our ears, our eyes, that we may hear, see, and understand. I am asking in the precious name of your Son, Jesus. And the body said, amen and amen. You may be seated tonight. I'd like to speak with this thought in mind tonight. A world in chaos. A church asleep. A world in chaos. A church asleep. In verse 43, it said, but know this, that if the good man of the house had known in what watch the thief would come, he would have watched and would not have suffered his house to be broken up. Mm-hmm. Therefore be also ready, for in such an hour, right, as you think not, the Son of Man cometh. Scripture was talking here about mentioned Noah. After the ark had been prepared, Noah had no doubt had ministered and preached to the people during the building of the ark. But we see here that Scripture says that as it was in the days of Noah. Folks, it is nothing new. Let me rephrase that. If this was going on in Noah's day, it's still going on in our day.
That's right.
For God promised, he said, I never again will destroy the earth by flood. Mm-hmm. But then later in Scripture, he said this, that he would send fire from heaven. Let me say this tonight. As it was in the days of Noah, they were eating, they were drinking, they were marrying and giving in marriage. Their mamas and daddies or daddies were still walking the aisle, handing the hand of that loving daughter to that young man. Amen. Then we think about Lot. And he said, look at Lot. Think about Lot. How that Lot was living in Sodom. How that he chose Sodom for a place of abode. How that he looked across the plains and how he saw the vegetation and so forth. Plenty to feed his flocks. his animals. But yet as he lived, as he moved into Sodom, thank you, Holy Ghost, as he moved into Sodom, he became comfortable. Well, the Bible said Lot vexed his soul daily. Amen. But the surroundings, do you know it's possible that we can get adjusted or adjust ourselves to match our surroundings?
Right.
Or at least to be comfortable with our surroundings. Amen. Amen. Oh, listen. As it was in the days of Lot, folks were living in those days.
Amen.
As it was in the days of Noah, were living in those days. Eating, drinking, marrying, giving in marriage. And amen. But then we go over to 2 Timothy chapter 3. As scripture tells us that in the last days perilous times will come. That men would be lovers of themselves. Blasphemous and unholy and unthankful.
That's right.
The church should be packed out. The church should be overflowing with men and women giving praise to God because of being thankful for Him and what He does. But we choose rather to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. We enjoy, we choose rather to enjoy pleasure more than being in love with God.
Amen.
As I was, and I'll get back to the message in just a moment. I've just been waiting on God's Spirit to give me opening to tell. I'm not one. On occasion, I may tell you about a vision or a dream that I may have. But last night, late into the night, somewhere between 1 and 3 in the morning. In fact, the matter is, it had to be between 2 and 5 in the morning, because I was up till about 20 minutes till 2, I believe. And as I was laying there in the bed, I had fallen off asleep, and I began to dream. And I saw, I just mentioned to my wife yesterday afternoon, or last night before we went to bed, it was early, probably around 8:30, 9 o'clock in the evening. We stood at the front door as a rain cloud began to move in. A thunderstorm began to move in. And I told her, standing out and looking at the winds blow and watching the clouds move in, I said, I want to tell you something. America and our world is going to see tragedy like we've never seen it. We're going to see cataclysmic happenings in the future like we have never seen them. We're going to see days that the Bible talks about as in the book of Joel. Dark days. You say, oh, why do you preach gloom and doom? Folks, I want to tell you something tonight, that when the scripture, when Bible, when the word of God speaks to our hearts and says, there will first come a great falling away. Folks, I want to tell you tonight, there are men and women who once were in love with Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Men and women who once were in, boys and girls who once were in love with God.
Yes.
Young men and young ladies who were once filled with the Spirit of God, who radiated by the presence of God living within them and dwelling within them, who on Sunday morning was up early and getting dressed and excited about coming to the house of God, because they knew that when they came, He was going to be here. And they were going to rejoice and worship Him in spirit and in truth. Amen. And they would be up on Sunday early. They would say, Mom and Dad, I'm headed to the church. I want to get there early. I want to practice singing. I want to get there and pray around the altars. Amen. So I'm going early. Amen. They had a desire. They had a zeal for God. God excited them. Their spirit was excited by the presence and spirit of God, drawing them. Amen. But can I tell you, saints just like the days of Noah and just like the days of Lot. Can I say to you, last evening as I lay in the bed between 2 and 5 o'clock in the morning, I began to dream and I saw cataclysmic things happening in our world. I actually, many years ago, I ran a bucket truck, was a foreman for a bucket truck clearing power lines for Davy Tree Company and Osmond Tree Company. And in fact, for a couple of years, I ran a bucket. I was not a foreman, but I just ran the bucket, trimming out the power lines. Amen. And I began to see a good friend of mine that was the foreman of the crew that back in those years. And I saw him, and as a storm came in, it was like a hurricane, and tornadoes, and trees were down everywhere, and power lines were down, and the wind was just blowing, just blowing wildly. And I looked, and I saw Brother Steve as he got in that bucket and began to take that 62-foot boom, High Ranger boom up to trim trees. Amen. He began to go up, I was standing on the boom, and I was controlling the boom mechanically. Amen. And as I stood there, Sister Rachel, all of a sudden the wind began to blow very fierce, and I saw Steve as that boom went crazy. Steve fell out of that bucket and the ambulance got there. He was lifeless, lost his life. And then there was another man there that I knew, and I began to see him as troubles began to press against him, and the storm had come. Folks, God was showing me through the Spirit that because men have said they do not need God, they do not desire God, and they pass laws and make it a law that these things will come to pass, the same as it was with Noah and the same as it was with Lot. Can I tell you something? We're going to see things in the future that is going to literally be mind-boggling. It's going to be astonishing when we see what God does by pouring wrath out upon this world.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. The Bible says and speaks about a day that would come when men would not want authority over them. What are you talking about, Brother Ford? Men, in telling male and female both, men will become angry with you if you try to correct them in these days.
Yes.
If you try to tell them that they are doing wrong, if you try to warn them, now listen, I'm talking about in the spirit of meekness, gentleness, and try to warn them and say, I am praying for you. I am concerned in the direction you're going.
Yes.
Men will fall out with you. They will get angry with you. They will quit church. They will quit coming to church. They will say, I am not going to let you tell me what to do.
Come on. Praise God.
Do not want authority over them.
That's right.
Leave me alone. I'm happy in the way that I'm going. I want to live my life the way I am. I do not want to hear about your God. Leave me alone. Amen.
Yeah.
Oh, listen, folks. We're living in that day.
That's right.
We're living in the time that I believe that Jesus should come right now. I've read this Bible through. I'm about to complete it for the 58th time. And I believe, Sister Annette, we're living in the time when Jesus is about to come. I see the Word of God fulfilled. And I see that's not fulfilled that is coming to pass right before our very eyes. Folks, I want to tell you tonight, hold to the blood-stained of Jesus the Christ. Hold on to God like you've never held on to it before. You see, listen, there's never been a time that we should have played around God in the beginning. But can I tell you, if there's ever been a time that we should pray, if there's ever been a time that we should fast, if there's ever been a time that we should be calling out Gentile dispensation is just about over. Amen. Folks, I want to tell you tonight from the depths of my heart, if you've ever held a hold of that altar, we need to hold a hold of the altar in our day that we're in now.
Amen. Yeah,
come on.
Amen.
Right.
Amen. I am so fearful that, listen, laws are going to continue to be approved through Congress, through Senate, through the President signing them into law. They're going to continue to come about. They're going to continue to happen. And until, amen, that the church has no liberty at all. So we need to win them while we can.
Amen.
But can I tell you tonight, in a word of encouragement, folks, I've said it before and I'll say it again. When the church is persecuted, the church becomes stronger. When the world says you cannot talk about Jesus, you cannot mention his name, the church becomes stronger.
Come on.
You say, well, I haven't. I hear these different ministers and these different ones talking about Jesus and how wonderful he is and so forth. And don't they know that one day they're not going to be able to speak that name Jesus any longer audibly? Because if so, they're going to be penalized. Can I tell you, when the church is suffering persecution, that's when men generally rise to the occasion and they say, in the name of Jesus, we live and we dwell and we're going to continue to worship him anyway.
That's right.
Amen. Oh, yes. Oh, listen, turn with me over to 2 Peter. Begin to read in verse number 1. I'll give you just a moment. I want you to read this tonight. Amen. As I dreamed last evening, and I saw the storm, and I saw those that were losing their lives in the storm. Sister Patty, we've got those that used to sit right here on these chairs, that the storm has come. And they're losing their life, Brother Don. Because, listen, folks, I want to tell you something. If you can't take it now, if you can't take the trying of your faith now, if you can't take the temptation now, folks, may I say to you, during tribulation, you'll never be able to stand it.
Amen.
So let's serve God that when Jesus comes and God gives his Son the command to return to this earth to catch us away, to get the bride of Christ, amen, to be forever with him in the air. May I say to you, folks, it's only he's coming after a tribe, people.
Amen.
The Holy Ghost just spoke to me and said, he's coming back after a tribe, people. Amen. He's not coming back after those, amen, who are manby and pamby.
Come on.
He's not coming back, Brother Don, after the weak hearted.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Come on. He's not coming back after those, who refuse to look around and lap water at the same time like a dog.
Mm-hmm.
He's not, Sister Patty, coming back for those. And may I say to you, come on now, don't fall out with me, but I mean it tonight from the depths of my heart. We can say we're Christian all we want to, but you let times get hard. You let it get rough. You let the pressing and the trial of our faith be so that we feel the fire burning the heels of our feet. Can I tell you, there are many that say that we are Christian today or that they are Christian today. When times get hard, Brother Don, you won't see them anymore. Amen. They'll turn and they'll walk away from God because they won't be able to take the persecution. They won't be able to take the test of time. They won't be able to take the trying of their faith. But can I say to you, Jesus Christ died at a mantle that we can stand the trial of the day. And we can stand
Praise you, Jesus.
Listen to what he said in 2 Peter in chapter 3 and verse 1. This second epistle, beloved, I now write unto you, in both which I stir up your pure minds by way of remembrance, that ye may be mindful of the words which were spoken before by the holy prophets, and of the commandment of us, the apostles of the Lord and Savior. Knowing this first, that there shall come in the last day scoffers, walking after their own lust, and saying, where is the promise of his coming? For since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they were from the beginning of the creation. For this they willingly are ignorant of, that by the word of God the heavens were of old, and the earth standing out of the water and in the water, whereby the world that then was being overflowed with water perished. But the heavens and the earth, which are now by the same word, are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men. I want to read verse number 7. Don, would you read verse number 7 out loud one more time?
But the heavens and the earth, which are now by the same word, are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and prediction and ungodly men.
And perdition of ungodly men. Folks, there's coming a day of judgment for the ungodly.
Right.
There's coming a day of judgment for the unsaved. Mm-hmm. There's coming. Listen, Jesus Christ died willfully, willingly for you and I, that we can be saved. Amen. Right. He laid his life down. No one took it. Man did not take it from him. He laid it down because he wanted us to be saved. Amen. He has given opportunity. He has made the way that you and I can serve him. Amen. And that we can live eternally with him in the heavens. Hallelujah. Oh, listen. But there's coming a day of judgment. And folks, instead of there being a great falling away, there should be an influx of hearts looking around and seeing the times have changed. And the times are hard, and they should be running to the house of God, falling prostrate over an altar somewhere, and calling on God and saying, God, I don't care about the things that I once cared for. I don't care about the things of this world. I don't care about those things that give me joy, that I have pleasure in. I don't care about those things anymore. God, I remember the time. Oh, listen, folks, there are many that once had the fire of God burning in their hearts, that loved God with everything that's within them. But somewhere, something happened, and they began to call on God, and began to walk away from God, and turn their back on God. And now, when you see them, they've totally changed. They're not the same as they used to be. They're not in love with Jesus anymore. They don't want to talk about God anymore. And when you're around them, and you mention God, they want to see how quickly they can escape. Amen. But can I tell you what we need? We need an old-fashioned Holy Ghost, God sent, devil killing, sin killing revival to come by again in White Springs Church of God and this community, and wake up the dead. Hallelujah. I can tell you something. Many today, amen, that once knew the fire of God has let the lamp go out. It's just flickering, amen. And some have completely gone out. Folks, I want to tell you something. There's coming a cry. There's coming a knock on the door. Jesus is going to be standing on the eastern clouds. And men, those that are watching, those that are looking, are going to leave here in a moment in the day that surpasses all understanding. When they were sick, they ran to God. When they were sick, they called on God. And God brought them up and healed them. Amen. When they were in trouble, when their children were in trouble, they called on God. And God delivered them from their troubles. And now we see granddaddy sitting at the house, and they're not concerned any longer about frequenting the house of God. Their lamp has gone out, and they know, and they've heard it preached to them through the years, time and time again, about the five wise and the five foolish virgins. Listen, Don, those five wise, they kept the fire of God burning on the altar of their heart. They kept their lamps filled with oil. Amen. Their wick was bright, was shining brightly. Amen. Have you ever seen them? Listen, you've seen them. I've seen them. Man, I tell you, I love to get around Christian folk. Sister Annette, that's so happy to serve God that when you're around them, you get happy.
Amen.
They'll grab you by the hand, pull you up and hug your neck, smile real big at you, look you in the eye, and say, Brother Ford, it's good to be saved. One day soon we're going to be with Jesus. That's why I'm serving him, because one day I'm going to be eternally with him.
Amen.
Listen, so many have fallen away. So many have let the oil run out in their lamp. The five foolish virgins, Sister Patty, we know the story well. There they were. Their lamps were flickering. Their oil was gone out. They were cold, actually lukewarm. And when Jesus, or when the cry came, my foolish rose up and they said to the wise, give us of your oil. Ours has run out. My, I feel it tonight. Folks, there are those that used to sit right here and hear the preached word of God. Amen. But yet tonight and today and tomorrow and yesterday, you can't find them anywhere in any church.
Amen.
They've got cold on God. They've backslidden on God. Brother Ford, don't use that word backslidden. That's not proper. Folks, I want to tell you something. God told me that there was going to be somebody here tonight, and I was hoping that they were here. Amen. But can I tell you something? Satan will get a hold of their heart, and he'll get a hold of their mind, get a hold of their spirit, and he'll say, don't you go down to that church. Amen. Where they're preaching all this Jesus stuff. Amen. And folks, but I want to tell you tonight, the Spirit of God, I told my wife just about a week ago, I said, God has given me something. I've got to preach it. He's laid it on my heart, and he's laid it on heavy. And I've got to warn some folks, amen, that they once were in love with God. They've turned around and walked away from him now, and that judgment is awaiting them. If they don't turn around and come back to Jesus, and come back and fall in love with him, and have a relationship renewed with him all over again. The Word of God teaches us that we are to do our first works over again. Amen. But Homer, that tells me that God loves us. He's not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. That tells me that he loves us. Sister Patty, and when we stumble, and when we fall, that his Spirit is there to help us back up again. That we can call on God and repent of our sins. I said repent of our sins. Amen. Has anybody in here ever had to repent?
Yes.
Amen.
I'm going to just get here just a moment. Brother Homer, let me see your hand. I'm perfect. I've never committed any sin. Don, do you know what the Bible said? We were all born in sin.
That's right.
From our mother's womb. Right. We have all sinned and come short of the glory of God.
Amen.
But it's because of Jesus Christ that we can be born again.
Right.
And it's because of Jesus' death, Sister Annette, and resurrection. If Jesus would have stayed dead and never resurrected, there would have been no remission of sin. But because he came, he lived, he died, he rose, and he lives again. Took the way of the world, took sin upon him.
Yes.
I didn't say he became a sinner. But he died that we could be set free from sin. And can I say to you that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God? Can I say that God gave his only begotten Son, Jesus, Sister Patty, that we can call on him and say, forgive me. God, forgive me. For I have sinned. I'm going to repeat it one more time tonight. I try not to use it too often, maybe every service, and that's about it. 2 Chronicles 7:14, so many times we've read together and preached about it. If my people will humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways, call upon Him. Turn from their wicked ways and seek my face. Then I will hear from heaven. I will forgive their sins. And what did He say? I will heal their land. That's what He said, Don. And what He said to the church and to the local body, He said, call upon me while I am near. Seek me early while I can be found. You shall seek me and shall find me after that you have searched for me. Don, it takes some searching. After that you have searched for me. Jeremiah 29:13. Ye shall seek me and shall find me after you have searched for me with all your heart. Listen, as it was in the days of Noah, as it was in the days of Lot, we're living in those days again. Amen. Someone said that time is like a cycle. It's like a revolving door. It just comes full circle and it repeats itself. I'll tell you, Brother Don, if we can take it, we can make it.
Praise God.
And I believe tonight we can take it. And what I came to tell us tonight, we're living in a world, a chaotic world. And Brother Mike, it's not getting any better. The floodgates have been opened. And it's been purposely opened by man. Amen. And it's only going to get worse from here. But can I tell you, for the Christian, it's only going to get better. They may strap us to the stake. They may lay pile of wood under our feet and pour gasoline on it and light it. And Sister Annette, we may be tortured to our death because we're Christian. But can I tell you, we can be like those of old that were tied to the stake and burned to their death. Brother Don, I read the story, and many of you have read the story about God's generals too. And I've got the book, or had the book, I think I gave it away. But then, all about the martyrs, the Fox's Book of Martyrs. Anybody in here read it? I've read it. You ever read it?
Yeah.
You'd enjoy it. It talks about all of those that were martyred for the gospel's sake.
Yeah.
Tied to the stake, wood piled up under them, and lit, and watched them burn to their death. But Sister Annette, there was something about those men and women. And I read the stories where just before they would die, the death, they would have their hand raised in the air.
Amen.
As a sign of victory.
Yes.
Loving God. Waiting on Him to come and get them. I'm trying to close tonight. But Stephen, a martyr, as they stoned him to death, Sister Betty, for preaching the gospel, they didn't like him because he told them the truth. They stoned him to death. But thank God, just at the point of when he was fixing to take his last breath, Don, he said, I see the Lord standing.
Praise God.
I see the Lord standing. What he saw was God was just going to take his heart and soul and just bring it right up to be with him. Folks, I want to tell us tonight in all sincerity, God is watching over
you and I. Is he going to keep us from trial? Absolutely not. We will be tried as by fire, but we'll come forth as pure gold if we endure till the end. Folks, we need to, will you stand to your feet tonight? There's no quitting. There's no place to turn around. There's no place to stop. It's almost over. We're almost home. And I don't want what's down here. I don't like it the way it's going. Do you? Can I see someone who wants to stay here? If you want to stay here after Jesus comes, would you let me see your hand? No one. May I say to you and I tonight in closing, I didn't intend tonight. I knew that I was not going to preach a salt message. Sister Annette, judgment's coming. Amen. For the lost. Reward is coming for the saved. But I knew tonight, Sister Kelly, I want to tell you something. They can fall away, meaning people. They can laugh at my God. And they can say how wrong they were to be in love with him. But can I tell you, they're going to stand before him and look him in the eye. Then there's going to be no excuses today. When Jesus, who died for our sins, on judgment day, has tears running down his cheeks. You say, oh, he won't do that. He's going to be fierce. He's going to be angry. He's going to cast them alive into hell fire, into the lake of fire. I honestly believe that a good Savior, as loving and caring as Jesus is, who cared enough to die for me and you, I believe that he'll have tears streaming down his face. Because he says, you once were in love with me. You once looked at me as though I was the Son of God, your Savior. What happened? And I close with this verse of Scripture. Ye ran well. Who did hinder you? Well, like the Lord of God doesn't say what did hinder you. He said who did hinder you. Folks, it boils down to one thing, Don. Are we in love with Mama more than we are God? Are we in love with Daddy or Granddaddy or Grandmama more than we're in love with God? Are we in love with our children more than God? Are we in love with our grandchildren more than God? That we would allow them to hinder our love for God? But listen, it all boils down to one thing. Sin has lied to the masses. Now I say this in closing. Sister Swords, could I get you to come to the music tonight? I say this in closing tonight. There are many people of all ages that if they had opportunity, they would be in this church tonight. And churches, full Bible-believing churches all around the world. Don, they would have never backslidden on God because now they're in eternity. And what's awaiting them is judgment, the great white throne judgment. They used to know God, I mean, used to be on fire for God, and they turned and walked away from God, and they went back and picked up the weak and beggarly elements of this life and made it their pleasure. Only to find out that an unexpected end came. We never know. I'm not trying to scare us, but we never know when we leave here and head home when someone is going to cross that center line. And we may wake up in eternity. We never know. When we lay our head up on our pillow at night, when we'll never open our eyes again on this side of life.
Massive heart attack. We never know. But can I say one thing we can know, and then we're going to pray? That we know Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
And love Him. We know He loves us. Sister Patty, I whipped this church with me back down tonight. I still didn't finish. I had more, and I wanted to preach and say to Peter. Don, it's time that the church wakes up. I mean the body of Christ wakes up. What are we serving? Sister Antoine, what are we serving God for? Am I serving God for notoriety? Am I serving God for my vehicles, my home? Or am I serving God because He saved me, number one, and because I want everyone else to have that experience?
Amen.
That's the reason we serve. Turning loose of this world. There's an old song we used to sing, and then we're coming to the altar. I live for Jesus and let this world go by.
Amen.
Sister Jolly, I've come too far now to turn back. To the weak and beggarly elements of this world. That's not going to bring me but a moment of pleasure. That's all it is, John. Bruce, that's all it is. Just a moment. Do you know pleasure only lasts a moment?
Yeah.
It may give us several hours of joy, happiness. But there's one who loves me, who I love, that I can have eternal joy and happiness.
Right.
Because on this life, we're just passing through.
Mm-hmm.
We're waiting for the eternal. Amen. I think tonight, rather than coming to these altars, is there someone in here tonight that you said, Brother Ford, I want to come to the altar and pray. Is there someone? Just raise your hand. I want to go to the altar and pray. Come on. Come on. I was going to do it differently, but the Holy Ghost checked me. Come on to this altar.
If you want to pray.
Gotten lunch and had eaten it and went down over to the old store over there in the corner, Sister Patty, and walked in there and looked around at antiques and my wife looked at me and she said, I'm married to one. That was all right. And I got to look at Sister Kathy, and all of a sudden, sitting over against the wall was an old piano. Kind of reminded me of that. And she sat down on that thing, and I walked over there, and the wife walked over there. And I think the lady's name's Linda, is that right? Brenda, that's it, Brenda. And we went over there, Dana sat down, and I said, Dana, let's sing that old song. This is just what heaven means to me. There was a man and his wife in there, and shopping, and looking around. She began to play, and sing that, this is just what heaven means to me. We joined in and began to sing, and the wife began to sing. Didn't care who was there. The life would have been like everybody, you know. Began to sing that song, this is just what heaven means to me. And the lady there at the store, Brenda, she'll forgive me. And she come over, and I heard somebody singing, and she was standing there singing around the place. This is just what heaven means to me. And then I thought about that and I said, oh Lord, that's what the world needs to hear. You know, they hear all the bad stuff. They see it on the news, they hear it on the radio. But they need to hear some good stuff. They need to hear how Jesus cares. And He loves them. We're fixing to go home, but I'd like you to sing that verse, that first verse, the second verse, and the chorus. And any other verses in that song? Sing it. This is just what heaven means to me.
praying the rapture don't happen right now. And she's looking at me like, boy, you're an idiot. I said, well, because you'll be closer to heaven than we will up on that mountain, and you'll go in first.
I'll go in first anyway.
Oh.
She's always got something to say, don't you? Y'all have a great time up there.
As slow as she moves right now, she needs to be closer.
Sister Baker. Now be careful. Because you were sitting there when Mary said that, you were going, yeah. And she reached up there, Sister Louise, and patted you on the shoulder like I didn't have anything to do with this. Don't you sit there, Miss Lady in Pink, and go to laughing. I told her before service tonight, Brother Baker, if you want somebody to straighten up, get her.
He's back.
Now I'm going to close with this. That Brother Mike sits over there. When they were saying that about Sister Mary, they were saying that about Sister Louise, Brother Mike was going, Now, we're fixing to go home and shake hands, but Sister Patty, I have to tell the truth. You can't lie and go to heaven. When Mary was saying that about Sister Louise, it hurt me. This man right here was saying, I know you're telling it right, Mary.